Amen. So we've come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Juliet Manning and Michael Lee, to ask for his divine blessing upon them and to share in their joy and happiness. Our Lord Jesus Christ was himself a guest at a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and he celebrated with them. And through his Holy Spirit, he is with us celebrating today. The Bible teaches us that marriage is a gift of God in creation, and a means of his grace, a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife give themselves to each other in love throughout their lives, they shall be united in that love as indeed Christ is united with his church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need and in plenty, in sorrow and in joy. And we pray that you'll have far more of the latter of that. It is given that with delight and tenderness they may know each other in love. It is given that they may have children and be blessed in caring for them and bring them up in accordance with God's will to his praise and glory. In marriage, husband and wife belong to one another and begin a new life together within the community. It is a way of life that all should honour and must not be undertaken carelessly, lightly, or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly, and after serious thoughts. This is the way of life created and hallowed by God that Mike and Juliet are now to begin. Both will give their consent to the other, they will join hands, and they will exchange solemn vows, and in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. Therefore, on this their wedding day, we pray with them that strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose for the whole of their earthly life together. Now, at this point in the ceremony, I would normally ask if there was anyone present who might know a reason why these two people may not lawfully marry. And I would also ask Juliet and Mike in turn today. But this is just the sealing today of the marriage covenant between them, and the legal contract was all tied up yesterday. So we don't need to do that. You can all breathe a sigh of relief. No one's going to come running down the aisle saying, "Stop! Stop!" So, you know, what is important between you today, what is of paramount importance, is the covenant that they are making between God and themselves. So Juliet and Mike, the vows you're about to take are to be made in the presence of Almighty God, who is the judge of all and who knows all the secrets of our hearts, and we're going to let them lubricate their throats before we move on. Bless them, they're both quite a cold yesterday. Okay, so Michael, are you ready? Michael Lee, will you take Juliet Lamb to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Juliet, will you take my plea to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Well, I do. You can go a little bit closer to each other. Mike, would you take Juliet's right hand in yours? And repeat after me. I call upon these persons now present.
I call upon these persons now present.
To witness that I, Mike Lee.
To witness that I, Mike Lee.
Do take me, Juliet Lamb.
Do take me, Juliet Lamb.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
And this is my solemn vow.
And this is my solemn vow.
Lovely. Keep holding hands. Juliet, would you repeat after me? I call upon these people now present. To witness that I, Juliet Lanning, do take thee, Michael Lee, to be my lawful wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish. Till death us do part. According to God's holy law. And this is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Okay, keep those hands down. I'm going to receive the rings. Yes, I know you forgot. Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Mike and Juliet a powerful symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So at this point now, I'm going to ask Pastor Len and I'm going to ask Pastor Frank to come, and where they're going to pray for you. If we could move the bride and groom gracefully over to the cushions where they will kneel and face the immortal, invisible, God only wise. Enlightened and accessible, hid from our eyes. Most blessed, most glorious, the ancient of days, almighty, victorious, thy great name, we praise this afternoon. We present to you your son, Mike, and your daughter, Judith. Lord, you have raised them up. You've watched over them all these years. You brought them before you this afternoon in the presence of a congregation to take a vow and a covenant in marriage with each other. We want to thank you for their lives. We pray for them this afternoon. Lord, I pray, O God, that you will continue to be with them, that your presence will overshadow them, that going out and the coming is always before you. The God Almighty, O God, that he would be the head that you have called him to be, the provider and protector of his wife. O God, for Juliet, O God, for her love and tenderness of heart. Oh God, I pray for her. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh God, that you will love her and show her your great love. Oh God, I pray in the name of Jesus, oh God, that all that they put their hands to will prosper. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that you will protect them. Oh God, from sickness, from sudden danger. Oh God, wherever they go, God, may your blessing overflow them. Oh God, I pray, oh God, that the principalities and powers shall not prevail over them in the name of Jesus. I pray, oh God, Father, that every negative word spoken shall be turned around in a positive way to bless them. Oh God, Father, that no good thing will you withhold from them. Oh God, that your goodness and your mercy will follow them all the days of their life. We thank you for this day, oh God. We thank you for them this afternoon. I pray that you bless them now, oh God, Father. And oh God, that you seal them, God, with the seal of your spirit that is present here with us today. We ask this and give you thanks. In Jesus' name, amen.
I want to put the Aaronic blessing upon you. Mike, Julia, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. And I bless you now with the Father's blessing of peace in your new home. I bless you now with the purpose that only Jesus can bring for your marriage. And I bless you now with all the power of the Holy Spirit for all that he has for you in the coming days. Amen.
Amen.
Love you both. God loves you.
Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonour others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always preserves. Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when completeness comes, what is in part disappears.
A poem, I believe, or certainly going to speak. Thank you, Ben. Give him a clap.
Congratulations.
Because your love has given me the validation to be myself. regardless of environment or the situation. Value you will forever be my occupation. E is for empathy. And I'm sure my own heart for you always have mine. So when you feel like you're misunderstood by the world, know that I understand you. And no matter where you are or how much you feel, know that by you is where I stand to you. Because my place will forever and always be beside you. Why? Why is for yours? Because that's why I'm CPI. I'm your lover, your partner, your rock. Your coach, your corner of the ring of life. Your burden becomes so heavy. When your burden becomes so heavy and you can no longer carry it, share it with me. So your struggles are and your load is light. Because I will always be your corner, fighting. Oh, always for obligation. My obligation to love you and to find your happiness. Not out of fear or fears, but out of love. You are my every treasure, treasure that I always keep and hold. From now until we grow old. You need some unification. As God unites us today, I know that no soul on earth can separate what God has joined. And I know His words are finally true. And my prayers were answered when I asked God to send an angel. So as this prayer comes to an end, I hope you can understand my thoughts and feelings. I promise to be your umbrella when it's raining, when it rains. Your torch in the dark. Know that this moment right now is where the rest of my life will start. And I know my words are true. And I thank God has given me the talent and the blessing to break down how I love you.
First of all, I'd like to say congratulations to Judy on the mic.
Wow, well done, thanks for getting it done.
On behalf of Peel and I and the youth, we want to give a round of applause to the newlyweds. We as Peel and I, we've all watched Mike time and time again put a smile on Jay's face. Through everything, we couldn't even do anything but sing in praise. Even though at times it has been hard, he's demonstrated he's a real man and stuck by him every step of the way. I couldn't afford if anyone else it could be a better fit. I would like to take a moment to remember someone who isn't here physically, but his presence is more than eminent. Phil, she's happy. Just like how you always wanted her to be. Phil was very protective of his mum, and I can remember distinctly a time when Sam, Philip, RTJ and we were on our way to their house, coming from Edward Station. We came across these three African men, a group of three, as usual. I think they were trying to, obviously, try and chat RTJ up, and, well, the scowl that all three of us gave to the three of them, was of such disgust and disapproval that it kind of lost interest. Well, Douglas said, we have always been very protective of her, and well, it's really lovely to see her happy. And now we're going to pass it back on to you. So, Phil, she has found happiness, and I know you have a gleaming smile on your face right now. So, let's celebrate. We fill in our hearts. Phil and the US.
Thank you guys. Did anyone else want to say anything?
course you can.
I'm back again. Sorry. You know what, yeah? EJ came into my life and I was so lost. And, like, everyone needs an angel, but we sometimes forget that angels need angels too. And I'm glad you found yours. And it warms my heart to know that you're finally happy. And know that I'm back, we will give you your blessing. And please keep comfort our mom and always love her as we do. Because you're now part of the family. So thank you very much.
Nice.
But yeah, I don't know where to start really. Well, I'm a leader of peer line, and I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for her. She saw potential in me, and potential I never saw in myself. Like, I'm thinking about 3 years ago, I would have never even had, even afford to actually be up here and do this. Well, I would have been the guy in the corner, just sitting there, touching everyone, just keeping quiet, but no one wants to be heard. And I thank you for letting me speak. I love you. And I wish you well. Thank you. Thank you, Auntie Lemon. She helped out the world as well. And yeah, have a great night. Auntie Lemon's great to you. Thank you. Put your hands together again. Come on.
So far. So let's say thank you for that. To the amazing, inspirational, and lovely Auntie Julia, and the newest family member, Uncle Mac. On behalf of us all, Bexley Academy, we'd like to say a massive congratulations on what has already been a lovely wedding ceremony. There is, of course, one gentleman here who is here in spirit, Philip Langman, who we miss every single day. Philip is looking down from the heavens on your Auntie Julia, saying how proud he is to have such an amazing mother, such as yourself. I know what Philip is saying right now. The words proud and love will be used repeatedly and rightly so. For the past 2 years, I've had the honour and privilege of knowing you, Julia, and it's been a pleasure. During times of toughness and times of where it was really, really bad and time to see everything was down, I could turn to you and look at your courageousness and your bravery to get you through and us through what was a very tough time. I wish you all the best, but now I have some words out of the mic. The Bexley Academy contingent is strong and powerful. We are incredibly proud and delighted to welcome you in to our lovely and big family. Yes. For the lovely couple, I leave a quote from Sophocles. One word frees us of all the weights and pain of life. That word is love. Love that is ever present between you both, and love that will stay with you forever. Congratulations, Auntie Julia and Uncle Mike. And I wish you the best of luck for the future. May God bless you both.
I'd just like to ask one more quick favor before we leave. Is that if you would all say congratulations to my Snapchat or as Julia, wait, hold on, let me get up. On the count of three, everyone. One, two, three.
Congratulations!
Put your hands together again. We're going to sing You Raise Me Up because Juliet has requested this song, but you are the choir, okay? So we want all of you to join in. The words, I'm told, are going to be coming up on the screen above you. So if everyone could stand, we're going to sing You Raise Me Up.
When I am down, and know my soul so weary, when troubles come, my heart will be, then I'll still wait here in the silence till you come and see why I'm with me. You raised me up so I can stand on mountains. You raised me up to walk on sunny seas.
Come when I am.
team and choir. So I think we can remain standing if you can for that worship time.
Hallelujah! This is a very joyous day. We're going to celebrate the presence. Lying hands in praise.
team, that was brilliant. And I hope that's got the blood circulating again to all of you. I'm not going to speak for a long time today, but I just want to speak about what kind of love makes for success in marriage. In his play, Romeo and Juliet, William Shakespeare asked the question, is love a tender thing? Well, it can be at the beginning of a relationship where everything is new and exciting, and it's about infatuation and physical attraction and romance. Who remembers that? And all these things are great, aren't they? But will they last a lifetime? If love remains tender and delicate, then when the first winter storm blasts its way into your life, it will be flattened, torn up, and destroyed so easily. So what does the Bible have to say about love? Jesus tested the heart of Simon Peter, one of his disciples. They were enjoying a big breakfast one morning, and he wasn't really prepared for it. He'd already let Jesus down, and he'd really betrayed him. And Jesus says to him, out of the blue, Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these? And he was referring to the disciples that were sitting around. And he said, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. He said to him, tend my lambs. A second time, Jesus asked him, and again he answered, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Shepherd my sheep, he says. Then a third time, Jesus asked, and by this time, Simon was getting rather irritated and aggrieved, and he said, you know that I love you. But each time, Jesus used the Greek word, the verb agapeo, whereas Simon Peter uses the word philia in response. And there's a big difference between the meaning of these two words as translated into the Greek language. Simon Peter was using philia. Philia was a very different word, and it simply means near affection, like liking a person, a friend. But Jesus was using the word agapeo, which means something so much deeper. It's the kind of love that God has for us. It's the kind of love that God places into our hearts when we come into a relationship with Him. It's a selfless, unconditional love that always prepares to sacrifice for the sake of others. Always more concerned about others' interests and needs and puts them before your own. It's the kind of love that helps us to stick like glue in marriage. We need to become experts in the art of putting our spouse, our marriage partner, before ourselves. It's about sacrifice. And what's the opposite of sacrifice? Selfishness. And selfishness is like a cancer in a relationship. Maya tried to outdo Juliet in putting her first and blessing her. And Juliet tried to outdo Mike in blessing him and putting him first, because what a brilliant marriage that will be. In Philippians 2, verse 3 and 4, it says this, do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourself, not looking at your own interests, but each of you to the interests of others. How appropriate that is for marriage. It goes against the wind that is blowing so fiercely in modern culture. The witch whispers, if it feels good, do it. Look after number one. A philosophy where the world revolves around you will always destroy your relationships. When it's exclusively about your needs and your desires and your dreams, because you will reap what you sow. One of the greatest stories about love is found in the book in the Old Testament called Ruth, where a lady called Naomi leaves her native land because of a famine and goes to a foreign land called Moab. And once there, she loses everything that she treasures, everything that is precious and valuable to her. Her husband and her two sons die, and she's determined to return to her homeland. So she kisses her two daughter-in-laws goodbye. But Ruth, one of them, clings to her with an utter determination. And she said, "Do not urge me to leave you or turn back from following you, for where you go, I will go. And where you stay, I will stay. Your people should be my people, and your God my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. This may the Lord do to me if anything but death separates you and me." In other words, as you said today, till death us do part. And she went on to back up her words with action. She lived out the promise, and she demonstrated in an unconditional, selfless love that what she received in return was mind-blowing. To cut a long story short, she ends up marrying a guy called Boaz, who absolutely adores her, who has a legal right to her, and from the lineage of Boaz came King David and ultimately Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
You see, God always blesses a relationship like that. When you decide to sacrifice for the sake of a relationship, you bring God's presence into your marriage. Sacrifice attracts God like nothing else. Throughout the Bible, we read about God meeting his people at the place of sacrifice. Whether it was Gideon, David, or Solomon. And when they would offer a sacrifice, the presence of God would come down, sometimes in the form of a fire. But God met them, and the principle is still true today. And it's God's presence that will make all the difference in your marriage. We read in the Bible that two are better than one, and that a three-stranded cord is hard to break. And when you have God as the third person in your marriage, you have more than an edge. God is love, and his love cannot be contained. There are so many emotions that we call love, aren't there? Often it's obsessional, which is all about delusion and putting the object of our desire on a pedestal where no human being was ever designed to be. It's a so-called love where we try and control and manipulate another person and mold them into what we believe that they should be. How many brides have said, "Well, he's got a lot of issues, but when we marry, I'll change him"? You won't. We're in love with a fantasy. And it's often a pathological thing. And this is often fed into by the romantic Hollywood stuff, which, although it has its place, is an illusion. Infatuation, mere affection, sexual love, all have their place. But they are tender and vulnerable, conditional and destructible. But real love is indestructible. Real love crosses every cultural divide, mocks social taboo, blasts through geographical barriers and breaks down man-made conventions. Real love knows no bounds. It's unstoppable, uncontainable, and unquenchable. Time and death cannot extinguish it. It has an eternal quality. Real love is indestructible and goes through the fiercest of circumstances. The hotter the furnace, the stronger it becomes. The darker the night, the brighter it shines. Real love. Tracy read about it earlier so beautifully. She said it always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. It never fails, and it always, always forgives and keeps no record of wrongs. So many couples say, "I forgive you, darling," after an argument. But the truth is they haven't forgotten. Because a few months down the line, when they have another argument, they say, "Do you remember when you said such and such a thing?" And it may have been 25 years ago. If you've truly forgiven, then you will make that decision to forgive as well. As Christians, we've been forgiven everything, haven't we? And Jesus loved us so much that he came willingly into this world to be a sacrifice for us and shed his sinless, precious blood and take the punishment that we deserved upon himself for our sin, so that we could be brought back into an intimate, personal relationship with a holy God. Forget about religion. Lord, preserve us from that. It's not about religion. It's not about ritual. It's about a relationship with a friend that sticks closer than a brother. And until we repent and ask him into our hearts and lives, there will always be something missing. A void that no one and nothing could fill. We were designed by God to be in a relationship with Him, our Creator. I have always been a pastor. And Carol, my wife, sitting over at the piano, we went through hell, we did, in the early years of our marriage. We loved each other, but we couldn't live with each other, and it was a nightmare. Anyone else experienced that? There's a few, can hear a few voices. Only when we'd exhausted every other avenue was it that we turned to God, who began a healing work in our relationship and restored us and put us back on the road again. And that was 30 odd years ago. And guess what? It was better than before. I hope my wife agrees. If only we'd realized and invited God into our lives back then and hadn't gone through all of that. Like Mike and Juliet, they've got God in their hearts from the start. And you've discovered that relationship with, and Christ shines from you. He does. And communication is the lifeblood of any relationship. Guys, men, we're not always good at it, are we? We internalize things. But we've got to develop that skill. Don't assume that your wife thinks you love her just because you go to work and, you know, you're doing stuff for her. You know, tell her every day. Tell her, if you appreciate your wife, tell her that you love her. Tell her that you appreciate her. You can do it now if you like. Won't put you on the spot. If we don't communicate, the little foxes will get in. Little irritations build up. Let your words always be words of encouragement, words that edify, because the power of death and life is in the tongue. Our destiny, the destiny of our marriages and our relationships and our families are in what we speak. No sarcastic remarks, no put downs. You know, we should be building each other up. Otherwise, use gaffer tape. I keep a big roll of it in the shed. Keep a sense of humour. Have you still got a sense of humour? Been married a long time? Anyone would tell you, you need it. You need a sense of fun. Don't take yourself too seriously, but take your marriage seriously. Protect it. Pray daily together. Pray for each other. There is nothing like knowing that your spouse has been listening to you, really listening and empathising, and is praying for you. It makes you feel like $1 million. Truly loved, with a love that is indestructible, flame-proof, storm-proof, affair-proof, adultery-proof, and backed up by all the resources of heaven to the glory of God. How great He is. That's going to be our next hymn, our final hymn. So if we could stand to our feet and sing, How Great Thou Art.
lovely couple. You stretch your hands towards them if you would. Lord, we thank you for this glorious and wonderful day. We thank you for the anointing that is upon Juliet and Mike. We thank you that you have plans to prosper them and not to harm them, and to grant them a wonderful future and a hope. We know you have plans for them that at the moment they cannot imagine or comprehend. But your hand is upon them. May your presence remain with them, and may your peace reign in their hearts and in their homes, and in the homes of their families. May you go with them in a very special way. And I just pray, Lord, that you would delight them in all that you do. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Take our dreams and fly. Together we can try. That's life. turning it down, isn't it?
Who's the one who can rise above? Take a chance to the hope for love and no regrets. Up ahead there's an open door and gotta find what I'm looking for. I'm on my way.
We're gonna have fun tonight.
All right. Please also make sure that Mike has a glass of drink in his hand at all times.
Yeah.
want Andy to try and shake his hips. All right, so we're going to get some dance moves going. Also to the sons of Mike, we want to see you dancing today, all right? Can I ask a favor, just clap your hands like this, ready? Pat, pat, clap your hands twice. One, two. One, two, clap your hands real loud. Clap your hands real loud. Let's go, clap your hands. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on.
Like Nobody wanna see you rising. And when they do, they don't even like it. They just wanna see you leave from crisis. Drive yourself, you don't need a license. All of us, you can even ride in. Go ahead with the feet just like this. Then they showed me the latest. Go for the latest. What you do, man, that's so cool. I'm so cool, I'm so cool. Now watch me do my so cool. So when you jump on the floor, better use it. First step is a step, step. You can move to the right, to the left, left. You can even freestyle when you step, step. Put your hands in your head and you're ready. So go, go, go. Twist your fingers, you can wave and say hello. Look, look, make a fist stand. You can hit it with that look, look, look. No violence, that's how you do that. So, so, let me see you go, go. Kill me, told me this. Nobody wanna see you rising. And when they do, they don't even like it. They just wanna see you leave from crisis. Drive yourself, you don't need the license. All of us, you can even ride in. Go ahead, move your feet just like this. Then they showed me the latest. Go to the haters. What you do when you're so cool?
You are my African queen. Hey, hey, hey.
You take me where I've never been. You make my heart go sing-a-ling-a-ling. You are my African queen. The girl of my dreams. And you remind me of a king. And it answers the African beauty.
Look at Juliet, she loves her reggae. We realize, okay, we know where you are, we know where you are.
What I see is paradise. Yeah, come to live in my soul. Like every day I want to fall for. I cannot deny this feeling I'm feeling inside. Ooh, you know I'm just gonna take your place. They cannot take your space. It's the fact I cannot erase. You are my African queen. The girl of my dreams. You tell me where I've ever been, yeah. You make my heart go sing-a-ling-a-ling. And you are my African queen. The girl of my dreams. And you remind me of a thing, yeah. And that is the African beauty. Hello lady, hello lady, hello lady, hello lady.
Everybody clap your hands, clap your hands. Yeah.
Let's go.
That you're behind him, baby. You gotta let him know you got his back. Alright, hold it firm, he's a man. Alright, are we ready? Now, Mike, you're taking them all the way around the room and back to the dance floor, alright? And if you love Mike and Juliet, you'll join them. Let's go. Oi, oi, let's party! I'm just helping my DJ for 5 minutes and I'm getting home.
Come on!
I've only got 8 minutes left.
Are you ready? I said, are you ready?
Let's go.
Can we get it? Can we get it? Can we get it?
a new dance note. Give me where I go, I mean the gang go. Festa. 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 Anywhere I go, I mean the gang go.
Look at the people, go! Go people!
Festa. Festa. Anywhere I go, I mean the gang go. It's speed and distortion. Ending careers, abortion. Do not approach, caution. Cause we're taking everything, no portion. We're in our own lane, M1. 10-man grumble, you're on them ones. It's a new dance, no tango. Anywhere I go, I meet you. Festa. Festa.
Hey, listen, this is me.
Festa. Anywhere I go, I meet
you. I've said Philip tonight.
Festa.
I know. All right, you ready? Let's go.
Yes, I do. Massage.
All right, if you want a bloke that will give you a foot massage,
A lady that will give you a foot massage. Come and join. You're not single, mate. Are you single? Come and stand right here. Open another button. I'll do another button on your shirt. You naughty sod. You're looking at what? She's blushing. Alright, alright. We're just waiting for the flowers to come and we're good to go. There they are. What a beautiful bouquet.
I caught it already.
You caught it already? All the way in Canada. Give your sister the flowers. Alright, ladies, now. You got to do the Beyonce moves. Let's go. Tonight we raised for Philip, we raised between 400 and 450. I just want to say that this wedding has been absolutely outstanding. And we have recognised Philip today. I'm sure that he's probably done a bit of a festa skank with us tonight. You know what? It's been a great evening. Are you enjoying yourselves, ladies and gents? Now listen, for you evening guests, you've got one more opportunity to give to this fantastic charity. I actually genuinely feel like the young man has been in there partying with us, especially when all the guys came out and was doing the festa. So listen, if you can put some more in the jug with us, please put some more in the jug with us. I would like you, did you enjoy yourself so far? Have you enjoyed yourselves? All right, DJ Chris, your time. Keep the party live, baby.
Ladies and gentlemen, big, big, and applause for our Anthony today. Absolutely wicked, DJ. MC, all the way through.
You teaser.